This is Claudia. I'm back playing Stardew Valley. This was a bit of a surprise for me today. I was supposed to go into work early today, and I work outside, and it's supposed to rain all day, so my boss told me not to come in. So shout out to Florida weather for being my best friend in my time of need. So I have made myself a nice cup of hot chocolate on this rainy day, and I'm gonna play Stardew Valley. So we, as you can see here, this was my boyfriend's save he made a while ago. I don't think he didn't get into the game that much. I, however, made it to year 3, and this was my character. A lot of time spent playing that. This is the one that I started last time, though, the one that we are going to be playing on. Let's see if I can remember. We didn't get too far. I think we made it through one day. So right away we're going to go over to the TV. Check the weather report. It's gonna rain all day tomorrow. Now, I know that sounds, you know, dreary, but that's actually, those are my favorite days because it means that we don't have to water any crops. It's already done for us. So the spirits are mildly perturbed. Now, I told you guys I was gonna tell you what the whole spirit thing was about. Basically, in some of the rocks sometimes, like these type of rocks, when you hit them, I don't think it's going to happen anytime soon, but there's something called a geode. Rather than a stone, we get a geode, and we can take it to a person in town, and he will crack open the geode for us. And on days that the spirits are perturbed, we have a lower chance of getting something good or rare. At least that's what I've heard. I don't know if that's super accurate, but that's how I play the game. I should probably look into that, but yeah, that's what it's for, and we'll see that later on. So this is an advertisement. I keep finding cool stuff, but my backpack is full. Does that sound like you? Well, Pierre's got you covered. Stop by Pierre's General Store today and check out our affordable size 24 backpack. See you soon. We actually already looked at the backpack, and our funds are a little short at the moment, so we're going to be getting it eventually. Hello there. Just got back from a fishing trip. You should come down to the beach sometime. I've got something for you. And that's from Willie, and I don't believe we've met Willie yet. We still have, let's see how many people. We have about 10 more people to meet. So that's what we're going to be doing most of the day, visit the beach before 5 p.m. We'll try to do that today if we can. If we can't, it's not the end of the world. So we're going to refill our watering can, go up here, water our crops. I'd like to start clearing out the area. I might cut that footage because it does tend to get tedious when you do things like that. The watering also gets a little tedious, but there are devices later on in the game that make it so that we don't have to water every day. And I look forward to that because when I was playing on like my file with all these kinds of hours on it, I didn't have to do this. So this is a blast from the past, but that's okay. All right. Oh, this day is just so good. I don't have to go to work. I'm in a reorganizing mood. I'm trying to get ready before my classes start because I know when class starts, I'm not going to have any time. So I'm trying to clean my room, to reorganize it, to get all the school supplies that I need. And I don't know about you guys, but one of my favorite times as a kid was going to the... Oh, here it is! There we go. We have a geode. The local blacksmith can break it open for you. Who knows what might be hidden inside. I love getting geodes because it's like basically a mystery rock. You don't know what's going to be in it. I said I was going to hotkey this stuff, and I intend to fully, but I have not gotten around to it yet. Yeah, as I was saying, the school supplies that time of year, it's my favorite because it's the time that... The time of year that I can get all new notebooks and stuff. Being a writer, there's just something about having like a brand new notebook that's like, oh, I can't describe the feeling. I just feel fresh and new. All right, I'm clearing out a little bit of space here. I don't want to get too into this. All right, that's good enough for now. I'm happy with that. Now, Okay, wait, what did I say? We were gonna get 50 wood so we could build a chest. And chests are super important because, like I said, to me, the most important part about this game is having enough space to... Or not having enough space, but, like, keeping one of everything, kind of. Because there are times when, you know, you'll find something, you might sell it, and then a few days later, you'll need that item again. Okay, yeah, cutting down trees is the easiest, fastest way to get a whole bunch of wood. So we already have 39. I'm gonna cut this tree down. That might do it. Maybe one more. But we're gonna build a chest so that we can hold all of these items that we're gonna find. And there's all kinds of ways that we're going to obtain these items. There we go, 55 wood. There's a fishing element. The combat element is seen later on in the game. But there are certain items that can be obtained from that. And fishing, I mean, gathering, foraging is kind of a thing. There's lots of ways in which you can get new items. Oh, shoot. Okay. We'll put the fiber in the trash. And we have a nice chest here. I'm going to put it right there for now. And we are going to, I'm going to open that up and put my geode in there. We're not going to go and break it open today since the spirits are mildly perturbed and we have a better chance of getting a rarer item, I suppose, if we wait until a day when the spirits are super happy. So I always like to check up in here because there always seems to be some flowers or something to forage. Not today though, it looks like. I quickly want to check in here. The bus stop. Okay, the bus to Calico Desert is out of service, so can't go in here. We try to do that, nothing happens. If we go down here, alright, we can go in this tunnel. It's basically nothing. If you look up here, it's a battery-powered lockbox. Unfortunately, there's no battery in it, so that's something to keep in mind for when we're looking around town. If we come across a battery, maybe we could pop it in there and see what happens. So we're gonna head into town now. It's only about, it's not even 1 o'clock yet, so we're doing good on time. Let's see. Who all did we meet yesterday? I think we have to go, oh, we never stopped in the hospital. First of all, there's a little exclamation point here. Help wanted. Trying to keep the art of fishing alive. I'll pay 200G to any fishing enthusiast who catches one catfish. Good luck, Willie. And that's the guy that we're meeting at the beach today. I will accept the quest. I don't see myself getting a catfish. There's no consequences if you don't get it within that time frame. But I'm going to talk to this guy here. This is Harvey. It's a pleasure to meet you. I'm Harvey, the local doctor. Okay, I'm Harvey, the local doctor. I perform regular checkups and medical procedures for all the residents of Pelican Town. It's rewarding work. So I don't have much experience using the hospital. I believe it's if our health is low, if we get into a combat situation. I don't know if they do anything with the energy, but there are certain ways in the game that you can, fix your energy level if you would like to do more. And as you can see, all the watering and clearing that I did today has already drained most of my energy, but that's just because we're low levels, I believe. This is Mara. She works at the hospital, I guess. Have you met my mother? She's the town carpenter. And that would mean that her mother is Robin. Can't go back here because this is Harvey's bedroom, I guess. Okay. Let me take a look. A little sip of my hot cocoa. I don't want to brag, but I make a mean cup of hot chocolate. I used to live up north, like the Midwest, like Wisconsin, Michigan. So I know all about the cold, and I guess that's where I developed my, obsession with hot chocolate. I mean, it's the summer. It's, 100 degrees here in Florida. And I'm still drinking hot chocolate. So, oh, we got our first cutscene with Willy here, the guy that we are meeting at the beach. Ahoy there, miss. Heard there was a newcomer in town. Good to finally meet you. I'm still trying to unwind from a month out on the salty seas. It was a big haul. I sold a lot of good fish. Finally saved enough to buy me a new rod. Here, I want you to have my old fishing rod. It's important to me that the art of fishing stays alive. And hey, maybe you'll buy something from the shop once in a while. And we got our very first fishing rod. You received a bamboo pole. There's good water here in the valley, all kinds of fish. Oh yeah, my shop's back open now, so come by if you need supplies. I'll also buy anything you catch. If it smells, it sells. Haha, that's what my old pappy used to say anyway. So that is Willy, and not sure we're going to get too invested in fishing right now. In the lower levels, it's pretty difficult. Let me see if I can remember how to do this. Okay, so that's the max amount, and the type of fish that you catch depends on how far out you cast, the weather, the time of day it is, your location. It's all dependent on that. And if we get a little hit here, this one might be easy for us because it's our first one, but we don't even have any bait here, so bait makes it much easier to catch fish. We caught a sunfish. Okay, not as hard as I remember. I remember when I first started fishing, I could not get the hang of it, but... And that's what a lot of other players have said, is fishing is actually one of the hardest elements of this game, like even harder than combat or anything else, but... I'm gonna pick up some stuff on the beach here. We got an oyster, a clam. The stuff on the beach usually sells for a good bit, and I believe we can sell it to Willy right over here, so we don't even have to go that far. Ooh. With 300 pieces of wood, this could be fixed. Because apparently we can't swim across this, like, 5 feet of water. We have a little shack here. It's locked. Only Elliot's friends can enter uninvited. So this is Elliot's place, clearly. And we're going to go back to Willy, see if we can sell this. So we have more room in our inventory. I'm not sure if I want to keep the sunfish or not. I probably should, just in case. Okay. Things like this that are pretty common, clams and oysters, I have no problem not keeping. The sunfish I'm going to keep for now. And I will show you guys why later on in the game, but I'm going to hold on to that. I've learned my lesson from playing the last game. Ooh, another element of the game that is really fun. You see these, I think the wiki says that they're sticks in the ground. I always think they're worms. I think that they're worms sticking up from the mud. But if you hit it, something will come out. Sometimes it's clay, sometimes it's artifacts. You just never know. And this over here, I don't believe is anything, or does it say anything? No. It's just kind of chilling there. Alright, so we're going to head back up into town. And here's Elliot. Ah, the new farmer we've all been expecting, and whose arrival has sparked many a conversation. I'm Elliot. I live in the little cabin by the beach. It's a pleasure to meet you. That would be a nice life, to live in a little cabin by the beach. Elliot is just the local Fabio, I guess. This is Sam. Oh, open the bush. Can I not talk to Sam? Okay. Oh, hi. It's good to see you again. Take it easy. So Sam's not much of a talker, but that's okay. And we'll see what we can find over here. We haven't been over here yet. Nothing down there. Let's see if we can check the trash can here. Nope, nothing. And we will enter this place. This is Gunther. Hello there. Welcome to the Stardew Valley Archaeological Office. This is embarrassing, but the previous curator made off with the entire collection. We don't have any artifacts for display, but I'm hoping to remedy that soon. Hey, if you find any artifacts or minerals out there, would you let me know? So we kind of have our first... task, I suppose. It's one of the main quests of the game. there's a book missing here. But we can actually go in. Oh, no, no. Nope. I guess that just means there's a book missing. So this is in this room here, these are all the spaces that we have to fill with artifacts from across the town. So we have a lot of work to do. This is one of the most rewarding parts of the game, though, because you can find so many different awesome artifacts, and they all have really cool descriptions. It's one of my favorite aspects, and it keeps it interesting. Okay, so it's open from 8 to 6. And it's important to keep those hours in mind, because you don't... Time is very valuable in this game. And this over here is the same out-of-order minecart. And it's locked because it closes at 4. Okay, but this is the blacksmith. We will visit Clint a different day to probably get the geode cracked open. I believe we met Clint in the bar. And we're gonna head over here to try to catch everyone we can. Let me see. Introductions. Okay, so we have 7 more people to meet. We have not caught that catfish yet, but we will do our best. Okay, the Stardew Saloon is usually a pretty good bet, but everybody appears is already there. Oh, wait, let's check the arcade, because every now and then some kids will go in the arcade. No, not there today. Okay. So we might not be able to meet everyone today. We'll do our best, though. That's Penny. We have already met Penny. We've already been in both these houses. Let's head this way. Just so you guys can see the area. Oh, there's someone we haven't met. We can catch her before she goes into our house. Come back! I want to be your friend. This is Marnie. Ah, Mayor Lewis told me you just arrived. I'm Marnie. I sell livestock and animal care products at my ranch. You should swing by sometime. I have already swung by, Marnie. You have a nice looking ranch with lots of animals. And you should be proud. Okay, so we have some things to forage and check out over here. Let's see what else. Just a good fishing spot. Have a nice tower over here. Don't know that it's going to be open. It's locked, you can hear someone inside though. Okay, so maybe it's too late at night, or maybe they just don't want the company. But either way, we are going to respect their wishes, and I guess we're going to head back home. I'm probably going to use my remaining energy just to pick that up. Clear out as much space as possible. It's getting increasingly more difficult to see where I'm going, but that's okay. I will find my way home. The cutoff time, our own personal curfew, which is the point at which I guess we pass out and we're exhausted, which makes sense because we do wake up quite early in the morning, is usually about 1 in the morning, I believe, if I remember correctly. So I usually try to be home by 12 or 12:30. Got some clearing out here. Some bushes. And this type of grass is actually different. That will be important when we get animals because they will actually eat that type of grass, whereas this is just like gross weeds, I guess. And we are finally back home. As you can see, it is very dark. It is 11 o'clock already. I'm going to these stones out of the way. Hopefully we get another geode, that'd be awesome. Oops. Yeah, this game, it's nice and relaxing, especially on mornings like this that are just like, I get to sleep in today and get to wake up and just play like a nice, fun game. I don't have to think about it too much. I kind of do. There is some strategy involved here, I would make the argument and say. But not too much. Pretty much anyone can play this. I'm going to do my best to play it well, though. Being a seasoned Stardew Valley veteran, I'm going to do my best to play it well and strategically. Okay, so we're going to go to sleep for the night. And we leveled up. We leveled up in foraging, and I guess that's probably because I guess we were using the axe, or because we have been picking things up around town. But yeah, we have leveled up. Trees sometimes drop seeds. Good to know. New crafting recipe is wild seeds for the spring, which creates the items we can find around town, such as like daffodils. And we have a new crafting recipe, which is a field snack. We are entering day 3, and you can hear the rain, which is awesome. So we don't have to waste our energy watering. It's going to be clear and sunny all day tomorrow. Okay, so we're not going to expect this tomorrow. Check the fortune tellers. Spirits are in good humor today. I think you'll have a little extra luck. So I don't know if I still don't know if I'm going to visit the blacksmith, because there's like a level 1 up from this. That's like the spirits are really having a great day today. They're loving you. You should definitely open that geode, and that's kind of on par. I don't know. I don't know if I'm going to open it today. I might just do it so you guys can see it. It is an exciting experience. Oops. Okay, so our inventory's full. That's right. I have to go to this chest. Put the catfish in there, and the clay, and the wood, and the stone. I forgot to sell the daffodil, and dandelion yesterday, so I'm going to stick that in there. We don't really need it for any reason. The daffodils do make good presents, so I might, in the future, might not sell those as much. But we'll see. Okay. Just kind of clearing out some space here. Wish I could get rid of that, but axe is not strong enough yet, so we're just going to have to leave the stumps be. I definitely don't need to use an axe for that. Stop. Okay. I've also been, yesterday and today, I have been listening to the Hamilton soundtrack nonstop because I'm a big Disney fan. Like I said, I worked at Disney, and the new movie Moana is going to be coming out, and Lin-Manuel, who wrote Hamilton, also came out with a trailer yesterday with him singing on the soundtrack to Moana. And I'm already like super excited for this movie, but just him being involved with it and a part of it is like, I just think it's going to be amazing. I think it's going to be such a good movie. And I'm so happy. I guess there's no romance in it. It's just a strong, powerful princess who has abilities, and that's all I need to know to go see it. I'm not that picky when it comes to movies. But yeah, I've been singing the Hamilton soundtrack pretty much this whole summer. Oops. Oh, another geode. Okay, so I'm gonna get rid of this fiber. And I'm gonna get rid of this pine cone. We don't need any more trees. We're good on trees, thank you. But I'll pick up those acorns, I guess. I can actually get rid of those in a little bit. Okay, so I cleared out a little bit. I think I'm gonna clear out some more later, but right now I would like to go and meet as many people as possible. As I take a sip from my hot chocolate at the same time. Tried to play this game with one hand, okay. And our inventory's full again. Okay. I am going to rid up the acorn. You know what? I'm going to pick this up. We're going to run back. We're going to drop it off because who knows what we might find up here. I want as much space as possible. We are all about trying to make that money. And nothing's going to stop us from doing that. So, I think after the end of this day, I will probably... Oops, I definitely don't want to do that. So, when you have it in this mode, you are actually able to take back the last thing that you shipped. I'm totally meant to just go to the chest and store it. So I got lucky there because I didn't click on all my stuff, because you can actually only take back the last thing that you put in. And then the horseradish, I will just go and sell. I'm actually gonna plant the seeds right now, and I don't even need to water them. I will just put them down and not worry about it. And I'm gonna go over to this horseradish and throw it in there. Now we're gonna go. Okay. Now we are going to meet all the rest of the people in town. I feel like I do hop on the bandwagon kind of things that are really popular, but in the case of Hamilton, it's well deserved. It's unique, it's different, it's closed up. What does that say? Railroad. Okay, railroad is up there, but you know, path is blocked, so we won't try to bother with that. In the case of Hamilton, as I was saying, I feel like it's well deserved. It's different, it's unique, you know. It's okay. I don't feel ashamed for jumping on that bandwagon. Totally didn't understand when it was first getting popular though, because I think everyone was kind of like a hip hop musical about America's founding father. I don't know. And people are saying now that, you know, by this time next year, there's gonna be a musical, the same type of musical about like Abraham Lincoln, which I suppose they're probably right about. Okay, so something's clearly happening here. Can't go in there. Not a whole lot to do up here, but we're gonna check out this big yellow tent and the house down there and see who we can meet. Because there's probably someone inside on a rainy day in there. And we have Linus, a stranger. Hello. Don't mind me, I just live out here all alone. Okay, so his doesn't have much here, Linus, but he seems like a nice old fellow. Oh, this tastes so good. I know I'm gonna, you know, not be so happy about it when I see my paycheck, but that's okay. Okay, so we have Maru, who we've already met, Robin, who we've already met. And this is Demetrius. Greetings, I'm Demetrius, local scientist and father. Thanks for introducing yourself. What a dad thing to say. Local scientist and father. All right. Okay, Demetrius, you do you. Let's see who else is up here. I can't go in the bedrooms. My phone keeps buzzing. Lots of soda. Interesting. What else we can really check out here? They have a nice home. However, okay, this is Sebastian's room, and we are still searching for Sebastian, so hopefully he'll come home and we can catch him. Robin here has her own shop, and we are actually able to shop for items for our home. So if for whatever reason we needed more wood and stone and didn't feel capable of finding it, you know, on our own, we could come over here and purchase it from her. She also has basic windows, small windows, and a bunch of birch, you know, collections of furniture here. Luau table, sun table. I like the sun table. It's expensive though. The calendar. This is basically just so that we don't have to go into town to see people's birthdays and stuff. Budget TV, we already have that. And then recipes to make a lot of our own stuff. So all of it is pretty pricey, and that's not really our biggest priority right now, but we can do that with her. Another thing we can actually do is upgrade our house. It costs 10,000 G's, and we only have 400, and also 450 pieces of wood. So I would love a newer house with a kitchen added in so we can make our own food, but that's not a possibility for us right now. Can also construct farm buildings. There's a coop which houses four coop-dwelling animals, houses four barn-dwelling animals, provides a place for you to refill your water can. I never, even in my last game, I never got this just because there was a pond and that was close enough for me. I always put my crops right in the front, but I suppose this is for if you know, expand and put your crops elsewhere. That would make sense. It's not that expensive. The silo is super cheap, but you need a ton of stuff, a ton of materials for it. It allows you to cut and store grass for feed. So basically, when you have animals in a stable, it allows you to keep and ride a horse. The horse is included with the stable. and a slime hatchery. Up to 20 slimes, fill water troughs, and slimes will create slime balls. We need a bunch of stuff for that. That is clearly late game, and we are going to head out. Don't see Sebastian, which is sad. Maybe we'll catch him down here. I'm trying to show you guys the most of this area. We have another daffodil. Nothing up here, really. And here we have a locked building that is clearly decrepit. Interesting. Mysterious, perhaps. No one is outside playing because it's a rainy day. So where is everyone? Okay. How many people do we have left? Four people. Only four people. So let's try and think about where they might be. I always like to check the saloon because I feel like that's where everybody goes. No one's here yet. We have actually already met Abigail. You know, I think I might have missed someone in Pierre's. He has a wife named Caroline. I don't think that I met. Oh, but it is closed on Wednesdays. That's right. That is one annoying part about the game. I guess it has to be closed someday, but it's just annoying when you want to go and buy something and it's not available. Help wanted. I'm looking for someone to bring me 25 copper ores to aid in the understanding of local minerals. 260G on delivery, and you can keep the ores after Clint inspects them. So we will accept that quest, but I don't see us completing it. That is for when the mines that that guy was working on become available to us. So they really try to, you know, make it so you don't have too much else to do other than introduce yourself to people in the first couple of days. We have a small, world's smallest cemetery right here. Our beloved Mona. Yep, different language. It's old and faded. Okay, sad, depressing. Let's see if we can get down here. The sewer, but it is locked. So yeah, there's really not a whole lot we can do right now other than introduce ourselves to people. I believe we didn't meet the kid, right? And there he is. Vincent. Oh, a stranger. My name's Vincent. Mama says not to talk to strangers, but you seem okay. Wonderful judgment. And he's on his phone. Clearly, there's like, this is the whole like single mom with a teenager and smaller kid thing going on. This is Vincent's report card. He's really good at sports, but not so great at his other studies. Vincent is a good boy, but he could make do with a little more studying. And that's from Penny. So Penny is a school, or she's a local teacher, I should say. Here's two more people. Have we already met both of these people? Leah, yes, I have already met her. And of course, we've already met the mayor, but we can always say hi. So how was your first night in the old cottage? Your grandpa used to complain about the rickety old bed, but I think deep down he actually loved that house. I think so too. I think that our grandpa loved this town, clearly to leave it to us and help us. Alright, got some worms in the ground. We're going to beat with a hoe. And two stone. That was disappointing. It's all good though. I'm going to see what else we can find up here. That tower that was locked may be unlocked now because it is, you know, normal business hours. We're gonna head down here. After this, I might take a nap. I haven't had a day like this in so long. It's still locked. Okay, so whatever. We don't have to go in there yet. I do want to see what's down here, though. Yeah, after this I might take a nap and just relax, which is weird to say because I feel like in the past couple weeks I don't think I had a single day off, which is fine because I like working. Like that's, I feel like that's what the summer's for. What it's supposed to be for is, you know, make as much money as possible, and then when you're not working, you know, you have all your time to yourself, but it just gets you sometimes. At some point, you need a break. You need to chill out. And I feel like I've struck, at this point in my life, I've struck a balance with that. Because I've been working since I was 16. So I'm used to that, but, I know my breaking point, I guess, especially with school and studying and having to do all that. So here we have some type of sewage tunnel thing, but it is, shocker, locked. Basically, no one around here trusts anyone, except for when they let you into their home uninvited. You just open the door and run in. We're gonna get rid of the stone because we can always pick that up. But here we got some nice spring onions that have been planted solely for our picking, it appears. How many people do we even have left? Three more people. Ugh. Okay, so we can't go in Piers to meet Caroline. I'm trying to think of who else it all is. Because I know all these characters, but I mean, there's like almost 30 of them. I'm sure I forgot someone. Oh, there is an area of the town that I haven't shown you guys. Let's go see it. I think this is the last new area of the town, other than, the unlocked or the locked places. But this is the Joja Mart. I believe it's closed. Oh, it's open. Okay. So this is Joja Mart. Fresh and cheap. And I guess this would be our alternative to Pierre's. Let's go. Is this lady, will she talk to us? No. Oh, she just sells us stuff. We have Joja Cola. Wallpaper. Parsnip seeds. I will have to compare prices, but just eyeballing this looks a little more expensive than Pierre's. Chia seeds, kale seeds, grass starter, sugar, wheat flour. So basically, as like all the same stuff that Pierre has, except for the Joja wallpaper. Morris, hello, welcome to Joja Mart. How are you doing today? I don't believe we met. I'm Morris, Joja customer satisfaction representative. So this is the same guy I think that wrote that letter to our beloved Pierre. When you decide you want to become a Joja member, I'll be delighted to help your transition a joyous experience. Okay, can I? Welcome to Joja Mart. How are you doing today? Membership is now available. With a Joja membership, you'll be able to make improvements in the community with the help of our dedicated personnel for a fee, of course. Oh, and another thing. Mayor Lewis promised us that if anyone else joined up, he'd let us turn that old community center into a Joja warehouse. Isn't that wonderful? I think that we saw the community center. It was the old rundown building that said Pelican Town on it. And we will definitely be exploring that later in the game. Membership costs 5,000 G's. Well, would you like to join us? Even if I did want to join you, I don't have the money. So we're going to say no to that. And this is kind of the last area, like new area to show you guys. Tomorrow, for sure, we will meet the last three people. We have Caroline to meet, oh, and then two other mystery people who I can't think of. What is this? Oh, this is an ore. So we're actually going to drop something here. I'm going to trash the dandelions, and this is a copper ore. So we need 24 more to give to Clint, but I don't see that happening since that was the very first one that we found. And I think it's like a 2 day, period of time, or window, I should say, where we can give that to him. But yeah, this is a nice day. I think I'm gonna take a break from Stardew Valley, take a nap, maybe do some work, clean up my room, and then I'll probably play it again tonight. What is that? What is that? You know what? I'm the world's best Stardew Valley player. I'm gonna sell all this stuff. Spring onions, I don't think we need to keep that for anything, that's just a forge. I'll hold on to the copper ore though. Yep, brilliant. So smart. Didn't have to drop anything. And then we will put the clay away and the copper ore. And if we click this little button, it organizes it for us, which is awesome. So we don't have to spend all our time doing that. It's about 10:30, so I guess I could break down a couple rocks and just talk to you guys for a second. I'm thinking of doing future videos, not really sure what to do. Like I said, I live near Universal and Disney, and a lot of people, you know, take videos and stuff in the park. And, oh, we got another geode, yes! A lot of people take videos in the park, and if you find that interesting, one of my friends suggested maybe checking out the new Harry Potter wand game, because I guess it's interactive now with the new types of wands. The wand that I originally got the first time I went to Universal was Hermione's wand, which is beautiful, but it's not interactive. It was one of the old ones. So I do get, working there, I do get 50% off starting around the holiday season. So I may purchase an interactive wand and show you guys how the game works. Or do other things. Can I hit this rock? Oh, because I'm using the hoe. That's why. It is getting late. I am going to go inside. I could definitely do other things around the park. Disney has so many new things this summer that have opened up. A new Frozen ride, a new castle show in the Magic Kingdom. Animal Kingdom is open at night now, and the big tree of life or whatever it is lights up. So I might be checking that stuff out and posting it on here. And if it doesn't interest you, that's fine. You can just watch the, you know, watch the gaming stuff. I don't mind. I don't think I'll sell the fiber, but that's it. I'm gonna try to hurry up because I think at 1 a.m. I pass out and bad things happen. I have 5 geodes, so I definitely need to get that taken care of. And I'm gonna run into my bed and go to sleep. And I would like to thank you guys for watching. We made a fair bit of money today. Almost 500 G's. Alright, and when we wake up, we have a nice, beautiful, sunny day and almost 1,000 G's, so we can start doing some stuff with that. Thank you guys for watching. I am going to be posting my next video maybe as early as tonight, probably more likely tomorrow. I hope you guys have a great day, and I will talk to you later. Bye!